It's important to keep all of your devices charged up and ready to go. You don't want to miss out on any photo opportunities because your phone's dead. Let's look at some of the options for chargers out there. I'm Emily Gazzulo, and this is Techbyte. There are a lot of chargers to choose from ones you plug in to wireless ones. You can now use them both at home and in your car. Best Buy's Nathan Roach says there are even wireless chargers that can work for both your iPhone and Apple Watch.
A lot of people will set it on their bedtime table or nightstand or whatever it may be. And when you get done at night, you literally just pop your phone down, pop your watch on the charger, and they both charge wirelessly for you, and you don't hook up any cables at all.
Keep in mind, you still have to plug in the wireless charger itself, even if you're not plugging your phone into an outlet. It varies how fast or slow it gets the job done.
Wireless chargers do charge a little bit slower, but when you buy a wireless charger, you do have the option to buy either a slower charge or a fast charge wireless charger. And it won't be quite as fast as a regular cable, but it will be a lot faster than it used to be.
So how do you determine how fast or slow a device charges so you'll know what to buy? Roach says it's not always about the cable you get.
It's really the brick or the USB device that they're plugging into the wall that is the most important. The amperage is what they really want to look at when purchasing a charger. Quick chargers nowadays are really designated as a 3-amp charger, which means it's going to be able to maximize the potential of how quick your phone can actually charge. A lot of people use older bricks or older USB ports that they've had over the years. A lot of times those are 0.5 amps or 1 amps, and that could be why your phone is charging so slow.
The higher the number of amperage you see on the box, the faster your phone will charge.
You're not going to damage your phone using an older charger. It's just going to go much slower.
There are even wireless chargers you can bring with you on the go.
And before, you had to take the portable batteries and plug them in. Nowadays, you have wireless charging available on those portable batteries also, so you can keep it in a bag or a purse, and when you're ready, simply just set your phone on top of it, and it will charge it for you.
And don't forget to charge that portable battery ahead of time. Otherwise, your phone won't charge either. Roach says the bricks can give you between 2 and 4 full charges. I'm Emily Gazzulo, and that's this week's Tech Byte.